This is part of the MOOC, the Precautionary Principle and Sustainability Transition. Topic 1. Special Protected Area Management and its Sustainability. The context of this video includes key concepts and purpose of protected areas, importance of protected areas, international trends of protected areas, and challenges for protected areas. Now let's begin with the key concepts and purpose of protected areas. Protected areas are the places where we aim to retain the extraordinary beauty and richness of the earth and all its benefits to humanity. They may include grand scenery, remarkable animals and plants, precipitous mountains, spectacular formation-rich caves, great towering forests, dramatic plunging waterfalls, immense wetlands and lakes, vast deserts and untouched coastlines, deep ocean mounds and expansive coral reefs. They can also hold landscapes of great beauty and cultural values created by human communities over time and through traditional management practices. First, let's talk about the history. The first park formally recognized in the world was the Yellowstone National Park in North America in 1872. The aim was to conserve nature in its primary state. Of course, many other forms of more or less official protection already existed. Sacred sites, for instance, were the forerunners in the field of nature conservation. But generally speaking, natural sites were protected for the purposes of specific activities such as hunting, which was destined for the elite during the Middle Ages in Europe. Protected areas concept soon spread throughout the world in 20th century, and new areas continue to be reserved in 21st century. The increase in the number of protected areas and of the surface they cover is a very recent phenomenon. Nowadays, more than 50% of the planet is under some sort of formal protection. We call these territories protected areas. Then what is protected areas and what purpose it has? According to the International Union for Conservation of Nature, protected area is a clearly defined geographical space recognized, dedicated, and managed through legal or other effective means to achieve the long-term conservation of nature with associated ecosystem services and cultural values. And it has a purpose of the conservation of biodiversity on Earth, as well as other natural and cultural heritage. Also, protected areas help to protect nature, and this includes biodiversity at genetic, species, and ecosystems levels, as well as geodiversity, including geoheritage, landforms, scenery, soils, and water. The IUCN has developed an internationally accepted 6-category system of protected areas. A specific IUCN protected area category is assigned to a protected area consistent with its principal management objective. This IUCN framework serves as a common language for distinguishing, describing, and working with broad protected area management types. The 6 IUCN categories are differentiated by clear primary management objectives, and this common language helps to provide uniformity for data collection internationally and the capability for comparative analysis for the global protected area system. The 6 categories are not designed as hierarchical suite of categories in terms of quality, importance, or naturalness. Rather, their application is situational and is based on maximizing nature conservation for a particular landscape or seascape context. All IUCN protected area categories are important for biodiversity conservation, although some key biodiversity areas may need special protection to ensure species remain extant. Such management may be the best established under the objectives and management guidance for Category 1 to 4 protected areas, Although category 5 and 6 also play a valuable role in contributing to such biodiversity conservation. Importance of protected areas. Protected areas are known today to be a useful tool to manage and to preserve the biological diversity. Protected areas are critical for maintaining healthy ecosystem and a healthy environment for people and all other species. They are essential for biodiversity conservation. They deliver clean water and air. They are vital to the cultures and livelihoods of traditional and indigenous communities for sustainable sustenance. They bring sustainable development benefits to millions of people through nature-based tourism, and they are critical natural solutions for climate change. They are also important for their rich history and the cultural associations they conserve, including grand historical sites and their special cultural landscapes, features, and sites of spiritual, social, and historical significance to a nation's people. Here we can see sustainable development goals. Protected areas have realistic and non-tribal links to all the SDGs, but clearly some are more significant than others. SDG 14 and 15 are closely and consciously linked to IG Target 11, and it is important that World Commission on Protected Areas tracks progress towards these goals, and importantly, seeks to influence the revised targets after 2020. Many other links relate to ecosystem services such as crop wild relatives, healthy parks, healthy people, water, ecotourism, and mitigation of and adaptation to climate change. Other strong complementarities exist in the areas of linking people to nature through the Nature for All initiative and the work on urban protected areas. International trends of protected areas. There has been good progress in expanding the coverage of both terrestrial and marine protected areas, with terrestrial coverage slightly increasing from 14.7% in 2016 to 15.1% in 2020. They are shown in green in this map. And marine protected areas, which are marked in blue, despite being fewer in number, cover over 6 million square kilometers more of the Earth, representing 7.3% of the world's ocean. Both terrestrial and marine coverage targets are likely to be achieved by 2020. Although, further areas will be needed for a full representation of areas of particular importance for biodiversity and ecosystem services. There are currently 244,869 designated protected areas recorded in the World Database on Protected Area. Most areas are on land and collectively protect 20,359,828 square kilometers, equivalent to 15.1% of the Earth's land surface. On the other hand, marine protected areas, despite being fewer in number, cover 28,665,325 square kilometers of the Earth, representing 7.9% of the world's ocean. This graph shows the growth in protected area coverage on land and in the ocean between 1990 and 2018, and projected growth to 2020 according to commitments from countries and territories. From this, we can see that marine areas under national jurisdiction have significantly more protection than areas beyond national jurisdiction, with only 1.2% of protection. This map shows the terrestrial protected areas varies by country. The shade of the country corresponds to the magnitude of the indicator. The darker the shade, the higher the value. The country with the highest value in the world is New Caledonia, with a value of 54.40. The country with the lowest value in the world is Afghanistan, with a value of 0.10. Challenges for protected areas. Protected area governance authorities and managers have enormous challenges in the 21st century. The footprint of human disturbance and change can be seen on every continent of Earth, including Antarctica. And transformation of natural environments has gained momentum, not diminished during this century. This video states three main challenges, which are global change, establishing new protected areas, and effective governance and management. Global change is a major challenge for protected area governors and managers. In the 21st century, they will need to deal with a shifting climate with its associated more frequent and more severe storm and weather systems, with sea level rise and the inundation of islands and estuarine and low-lying areas, and with the melting of many mountain glaciers and the transformation of perennial streams to ephemeral streams. These changes will see enhanced threats from drought, flooding rains, and incidents such as wildfire, and the effects of storm surges will be more frequent and require new skills, responses for protected area professionals. It will be a world of increasing human population and associated increasing demand for Earth's finite sources, increased industrialization, globalized commerce, instant communication, and the result in transformation and reduction in area of natural habitats, impact on Earth species. Increased tension and conflicts are potentially major issues as human demands and industries endeavor to access existing protected areas, and threats from outside park boundaries impact on the health of the ecosystem and species. Second challenge is establishing new protected areas. There is inadequate coverage of protected areas on Earth. Only 15.1% of the Earth's terrestrial area and 7.9% of its marine environment are under officially recognized protected areas, and this is not enough to adequately conserve Earth's species. This challenge was identified by the Convention on Biological Diversity Strategic Plan 2011-20 and especially Target 11. By 2020, at least 17% of terrestrial and inland water areas and 10% of coastal and marine areas, especially areas of particular importance for biodiversity and ecosystem services, and conserved through effectively and equitably managed, ecologically representative and well-connected systems of protected areas and other effective area-based conservation measures, and integrated into the wider landscapes and seascapes. Establishing exactly where new protected areas are needed is critical, and a gap analysis supported by systematic conservation planning approaches is often used to achieve this. The last challenge is effective governance and management. The practice of protected area governance and management is an essential profession for facilitating a healthy environment for helping to conserve life on Earth. Ideally, it is underpinned by both formal tertiary level protected area governance and management qualifications and vocation-based training, and achieving this standard is a global challenge. Achieving effective governance for protected areas is vital. Organizations and communities will need to be adaptive and responsive to changes, and local professional protected area managers will need to have the freedom to manage, albeit with established statutory, corporate and planet guidelines, as well as with community input and guidance. Evaluating the effectiveness of all of this professional management activity and reporting on the good work are fundamental for the future. Achieving a minimum professional standard of protected area governance and management for all protected areas on Earth provides a fundamental contribution to the conservation of life on Earth.
Thank you very much for your attention.